Good morning, children. Welcome to mathematics class. In the previous class, we were discussing about word problems. So, page number 17. So, today let's continue this. I gave you to solve some examples of these, and I gave the hint also of the question number 6. So, today we will solve this. Sixth question. What is the question first? Read it out, understand it, then you will be easy to solve the problem. A machine on an average manufactures 2825 screws a day. In a day, one machine manufactures 2825 screws. How many screws did it produce in the month of January 2006? Okay, now write the question in your paper. I will write the solution. Solution in the sense, whatever the data is there in the question, in word problem, that we should write it first. Then we have to solve. What is the data? Screws manufacturing in a day. Screw manufacturing in a day is equal to how much? 2825. Okay. Days in the month of January 2006 is equal to 31 days. So, screws will manufacture in the month of, in the whole month of January is equal to this multiply by this 2825 into 31 you should do. Okay, one day the machine is manufacturing 2825 screws. In a month, in full 1 month, how many screws it will going to be manufactured? So 31 days will be there in the January 2006. So 31 into those many screws if we do, then we will get the answer. So what is that? 2825 into 31. Write it in the column. 31 months a table if you don't know. So do like this. 1 5 is a 5. 1 2 is a 2. 1 8 is a 8. 1 2 is a 2. Then 3 5 is a 15. 3 2 is a 6 plus 1 7. 3 8 is a 24 plus 1. 25. 3 2 is a 6 plus 2. 8. Add the both. 7, 15, 5, 6, 7, 8. Then this is 8. So, once again check it out. 1 5 is a 5, 1 2 is a 2, 1 8 is a 8, 1 2 is a 2. Then 3 5 is a 15, 3 2 is a 6 plus 1, 7, 3 8 is a 84. Why we have written here 5, 4, so 24, 3 2 is a 6 plus, once again 3 5 is a 15, 4567, it will become 7. 7,575 crews will manufacture in the month of January 2006. So this is how to solve the word problems. So the problem, if you understand, then you can write in detail. Screws manufacturing in a day, this much. Days in the month of January 2006 is 31. Screws will manufacture in the month of, in the whole month of January, is equal to this number of screws into 31 days. Do the multiplication, then you will get the answer. Thus is compulsory to write in the word problems. So write this in your paper, and next we will go for 7th question. Read the question. A merchant had 78,592 rupees with her. She placed an order for purchasing 40 radio sets at 1,200 rupees each. How much money will remain with her after the purchase? Okay. Now write the solution. Merchant had amount A. Merchant had amount is equal to how much rupees she was having? 78,592. She placed an order of purchasing 40 radios. Number of radio, number of radio ordered is equal to 40. Yes, at the rate of price of the radio per one, the price of one radio is equal to how much? 1,200. Okay? Understand the things whatever they have given. How much money will remain with her after the purchase? Okay. See, she is having a merchant is having this much amount. And she placed the order of 40 radios. And each radio is 1,200. First, what we need to identify is the amount of 40 radios we should identify. So, one radio is 1,200. So, what will be your 40 radios? So, this into this we should do now. Okay? The price of 40 radio is equal to 1,200 into 40. So what will be the answer? Do 1,200 into 40. 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0. If we multiply 0 with any number, you will get answer 0 itself. 4 zeros are 0, 4 zeros are 0, 4 twos are 8, 4 ones are 4. So 0, 0, 0, 8, 48,000. So it will become 48,000. So the cost or price, the cost of 40 radios is equal to 48,000. Now how much amount will remain with her? Amount remain means we should do subtraction. So total amount is 78,592. So the radio amount is 48,000. Do the subtraction, write in column 78,592 minus 48,000. Do subtraction. 8 minus 8, 0. 7 minus 4, 3. So how much amount will remain? Thus, ₹30,592 will remain with her after purchasing 40 radios. I hope you understood the problem. There is a merchant. The lady is a merchant. She was having 78,590 rupees with her, and she placed 40 radio order. So she brought in order means she purchased 40 radios, and each radio cost is 1,200. So first what we should identify is the cost of the 40 radios. So for that we need to multiply the one radio amount into 40 rupees. Sorry, 40 radios. So that time we will get 48,000 is the amount of 40 radios. Then how much amount she was having? From that we have subtracted 48,000 amount. So the remaining amount is 30,592. Okay, write this answer in your textbook. And next we will go for 8th question. So word problem means these will be very easy, but you should understand the meaning of it. Okay, these are all are related to daily life. Now the question of 8th one. A student multiplied 7,236 by 65 instead of multiplying by 56. By how much was his answer greater than the correct answers? Now see. Solution. The student multiplied number is, the student multiplied number is equal to 7,236 into 65. The student has to multiply
₹7,236
into 56. See here, there is a student. She has to do 7,236 into 56. But what she has done? She has done this one. So now they are asking, if she has done this, but she has to do this. Now she has done this, so what will be the more answer from from if she done this. So for this what we have to do is, first you multiply this one, multiply the actual number, and you subtract this one from this one answer, we will get the difference. Now do this first one. 5 2 10 plus 1 11, 5 7 35 plus 1 36, 6 6 36, 6 3 18 19 20 21, 6 2 12 13 14, 6 7 42 plus 1 43. So once again you check it, 5 6 30, 5 3 15 plus 3 18, 5 2 10 plus 1 11, 5 7 35 plus 1 36, 6 6 36, 6 3 18 19 20 21, so 6 2 12 13 14, 6 7 42 plus 1 43. So add this, 8 plus 6 14, 1 2 3, 6 plus 4 10, 3 3 6 plus 1 7, and 4. Answer will be 470,340. This she has done in the mistake, but actually she has to do this. 6 6 are 36, 6 3 are 18 19 20 21, 6 2 are 12 plus 2 14, 6 7 are 42 plus 1 43 plus 5 6 are 30, 5 3 are 15 plus 3 18, 5 2 are 10 plus 1 11, 5 7 are 35 plus 1 36. So 6 plus 1 8 plus 4 12, 3 4 5, 6 plus 4 10, 3 plus 1 4. This has become 405,216. So what they are asking? So what her answer will be greater than, how much greater than this? So if we do minus from this to this, we will get the answer. Okay? What we should do right is, how much was his answer greater than the correct answer? Okay? The answers is equal to, this is big, so 470,340 minus 405,260. So write in vertical and write the answer. So answer will be 65,124. You have to write like this. 470,340 minus 405,260. Then you do the subtraction. So 10 minus 6 4, 4 minus 2 2, 3 minus 2 1, again 10 minus 5 5, 7 minus 1 6, 4 minus 4 0. So 65,124. Then you have to write the thus. Thus, I'll write here thus. Just you write down. Okay. Thus. How much answer? 65,124 was his answer. Problem these are. So the student, he has to do multiplication of this 7236 into 56. He has to do, but by mistake he has done 65 multiplication. So what was that answer? By mistake he has done this, and what has to be the exact answer? This both we should do, and then we should identify the greatest difference of both the answers. So we have done here. So thus 65,124 was his answer greater than the correct answer. Okay. I hope you understood this. And the next 9, 10, 11, 12 questions we will solve in the next class. Okay. These are quite big answers, quite big questions. We need to understand more time to these questions, and these will be in a big, answers also will be in big, so that you need your attention towards the question, then only you can write this easily. And you try the next questions also to write in a rough notebook, and tomorrow in the next session I will write on the board, and just you think how you are thinking, how you are solving, whether that was correct or not. Yes? Thank you.